Hey there. So I'm going to show you another way, another image to make as a pattern. Here's one. It's fairly cute. There's also another one here. This is how I got it from the internet. Then I take a clean screenshot of it, crop it well, and save it as a JPEG. So it's a photograph, essentially. Then I will open up the project that's associated to this bird. And on the left, it shows all the colors that it associates with it. It gives you the DMC matching thread and how many stitches. These symbols, if you treated your pattern with symbols, then that would be what you would follow, similar to a cross stitch. So here's the image. Bottom right corner, it's showing me 200 by 200. Now, I don't want that big because I think it's too big. So what if I do 100? By 100. So it's 25 inches and 25 inches. Redesign it. It shrinks it. When you zoom in, then you can see this flower here is actually nice and crisp. The other ones need a little work. There's a leaf. So then what I do is I grab my pen tablet, and I just start kind of figuring out where I want to start, which colors we want to keep, how the lines go. And something I recently learned was having a black outline gives you a lot of bobbins, but I'm not sure how to do it if it was just one color. I think the two colors make it look really nice. I'm going to show you a different image. We're just going to exit out of this. I'm going to go back to this image. I'm going to open up my software. Now with yarn, we have to make it 4 per inch. Maximum colors, 10 at the most. Don't dither. Dither adds like a feathering, so it blends the colors better. Whereas when you have a cartoon image, it looks better with it out dithered. Import a stitches. I picked my DMC thread. Now there's a lot of DMC choices, so I want the basic one, and I can preview it. Let's preview. All right, so it's obviously overblown. I'm going to go in here, I'm going to resize it again. So it's telling me 920, so I want 120 by 123. I'll keep it like that. Ooh, that's terrible. So I just do undo. goes back to what it was. Now, click keep ratio. We go 120. Oh, but it's only by 68. So let's say 140. That's not very wide. Like, you need at least 100. I go 200. It's 113. I go 188, 82, 81, 80. Yeah, so you'll keep the same ratio. So 180 by 102. And there's better. And now zoom in. And you'll see that the wheels, they touch the very edges. Now I like a border. You know, I like a couple rows of a different color, but I guess if it doesn't matter. And so in this instance, if you were to start at the bottom with this foundation color, and then you already have a color change, my advice would be just to add another row first. And then it creates a lot of creativity and you've got to fix it. So what I might do then, looking back at this original image, it is right to the edge. So what I can do is kind of manipulate it a little here just by pulling my cursor around. I'm kind of resizing this. There. Okay, I either get a little bit at the side or the, not the bottom. Okay, so if we just open it up like this, I'm going to take a screenshot, but I'm going to pretend that there is excess on the edges. So I'm kind of like making my own size. So I'll do that. Then we're just going to import that image into the new project. Just go find it. Here it is. Do the same thing. Move everything to 4 stitches, 10. Okay, so then you've got that. It's not bad. I'll hit okay. Check the size, 200 by 113. It's 50 inches by 28 inches. So now, it's a little better because this bottom wheel now is placed in a better spot. And what you can do is then if I grab my pen, I just select that black and then I just kind of draw it in little by little for proportion. Okay. Oops, let's undo that there. Now I can, and also I can zoom in. So if I was to do this, wrong way. Scroll over here somewhere. Oops, I'm not sure what happened with the view there. zoom way in and color in. Add the little, I'm just, now I have to replace all these colors. The ones that I don't want, I'm gonna replace. I'm gonna keep the ones I do. And I'm gonna reduce the number of colors that I'm gonna use for this pattern. And I go through it and I color each one. And it is a little time consuming. So when you find an image that you want, it needs to be special. Because it does take time. All right, and that's how I begin to make a pattern. Thanks for watching.